Hi, have you experienced an event when your child wants something or gets frustrated or pain, and then they will hold their breath until you give them what they want, or they will pass out and scare you to death? Welcome to the terrible twos, my friend. This is a real medical condition that is called breath holding spells, and it happens to little children. And we will talk today in details about what are breath holding spells, what is the causes, and how we can prevent them and treat them so that do not happen at all. And no one better to explain breath holding spells than our friend in Despicable Me.
It has been disintegrated. By definition, it cannot be fixed. That's freaking me out. What is she doing?
She's gonna hold her breath until she gets a new one.
Ugh. It is just a toy. Now stop it. Okay, I'll fix it.
What are breath holding spells? Breath holding spells is a common reflex that happens in children between 6 months of age and 2 years in the majority of cases, and about 90% will start at the age of 18 months old. It usually starts when the child experiences sudden shock, pain, or frustration, or you tell them no about something that they really want, which can cause them to hold their breath involuntarily. These are some examples of real children having breath holding spells. Oh my God, I really feel short of breath just watching those poor kids going through those events. There are two types of breath holding spells, cyanotic and palate breath holding spells. Like what? Yes, like we're doctors, we make fancy words to look smart. Well, here's the explanation. Cyanotic breath holding spells or blue breath holding spells are spells that happens when the child stops breathing, and that leads to decreased oxygen flow, which makes them look cyanotic or blue or pale, and this is due to lack of oxygen circulating. And the second one is called pallid breath holding spells or limb breath holding spells. This happens, and it is more rare but serious, when the child holds their breath, and that leads to an autonomic reflex which drops their blood pressure and heart rate, which can lead them to passing out and becoming limp. This is a dangerous condition because it can be misdiagnosed as epilepsy, because when the brain is deprived of oxygen and blood pressure, then they can have stiffening at the beginning, arching their back, and then they might have some jerks as well. And this can be diagnosed as epilepsy, which is incorrect and given the wrong treatment. The symptoms of breath holding spells starts with the triggering event of frustration, pain, or tell them no, and then the child will stop breathing, and then they go into a state of being blue or cyanotic, and then they might become pale, and they might become stiff and lose consciousness. And sometimes that can lead to a few twitches as the brain is kind of confused and in and out of oxygen, and this can be misdiagnosed with epilepsy, as we said. And you know that sometimes when you deprive the brain of enough oxygen and blood pressure, it can induce real seizures, and we have kids that went into epileptic seizures because of those breath holding spells. And in rare cases, some children went into status epilepticus, which is like non-stop seizures. They went into big seizures, did not stop until they needed to go to the hospital and stay in the ICU. So it can be serious in some cases, rarely, luckily. What causes breath holding spells? The exact cause of breath holding spells is still unclear. However, we noticed that children with iron deficiency or low iron, they might have breath holding spells, and fixing the iron will help to improve those breath holding spells. There is a role for the autonomic nervous system, which is the system of the nerves that control the blood pressure and heart rate and breathing. And sometimes there is a disturbance in that autonomic nervous system, which tends to mature with time. And that's why those breath holding spells can improve. There's always a genetic tendencies, and about a third of cases of breath holding spells, their children will have breath holding spells. So Like you scared your parents when you were a child, now your kids are scaring you. Just a payback. Here are some triggers of breath holding spells. Pain or discomfort, frustration or anger, emotional distress, sudden scare or shock, overstimulation, and physical exhaustion. How to make the diagnosis and testing for breath holding spells. The diagnosis of breath holding spells depends a lot on the features of the event and the event cascade from the trigger all the way to the end of the event. So taking a detailed history, and if you have a video, is very helpful to differentiate between breath holding spells and other causes or seizures. It is important to evaluate for seizures, of course, and it is best done by a neurologist who has experience in seizure disorders and in pediatrics. And we can do an EEG, a brainwave test, to check if there is any epileptic activity. Also, doing a blood work is essential. It is well known that we found that kids with breath holding spells often have anemia and iron deficiency, low iron in their blood. So getting a CBC, complete blood count, and iron studies is essential, because fixing that can help a lot in treating of the breath holding spells. Also, checking lead levels is important, because lead excess can lead to those events. Also, checking any heart issues, such as asking all of the family members if they have any cardiac issues, heart-related sudden death in the family, and evaluating the child's heart by listening to the heart and doing EKG, which is testing the electricity of the heart, it might find some rare causes of heart arrhythmias leading to those passing out events. The worst thing we can do is misdiagnose breath holding spells as epileptic seizure and start treating the child and label them as epileptic and give them. I have seen many cases of misdiagnosis of breath holding spells as seizures, because they get limp and might twitch a little bit, and then inexperienced doctor can diagnose them with epilepsy, which is incorrect. So that's why it is important to consult with a pediatric neurologist and a neurologist specialized in pediatric and children. They have better evaluation experience and they can get to the right diagnosis. How we can treat breath holding spells? The good news is that breath holding spells, most of the children will outgrow this condition by the age of 4, and the majority and rarely can reach up to age 8. And the neurological development is often normal. First treatment is behavioral modification, which is preventing those events that can trigger the situation that can trigger the breath holding spells. Sometimes there is a toy the child always keeps asking for, or the situation outside or inside. So you train yourself how to not react to the children all the time, and train yourself and avoid any situation that can trigger. But you know, I have children myself, I know that this is sometimes completely unavoidable, so we do our best. The second thing we found, that iron supplementation is very, very helpful in children with breath holding spells, especially if they have anemia and low iron levels. You supplement the iron, and that helps to decrease the frequency and intensity of those breath holding spells. But iron in patients with normal iron studies and no anemia is controversial. It might not really help, but it is worth trying. Some studies tested theophylline as a medication for treating breath holding spells. This obviously have to be prescribed and given by an experienced neurologist. And we know that anti-seizure medications will not improve the breath holding spells, and it can even cause side effects that can affect the child. So the diagnosis is important yet again. On the other hand, there are some dangerous movement and seizures in children. If they are missed as epileptic seizures, the child will suffer sometimes irreversible damage. So it is very, very important to notice these types of seizures in children and make the correct diagnosis, because sometimes they are misdiagnosed and they are called infantile spasm. And you can see this video for all the details about this dangerous condition. So make sure to see this video, because it's very important. It can save the child's life if you diagnose it correctly and treat it early. And stay healthy, and see you in the next one. Salam.